Good morning, students. Let's welcome back to electronics. Till yesterday, we have studied semiconductors. Semiconductor is a very interesting topic. So, I thought of starting semiconductors as a first chapter. So, we have studied up to junction diode. That means the first component of a electronic component of a semiconductor. So, to understand clearly the semiconductor circuits. Now, in semiconductors, we are going to study the circuits which are using diodes and further electronic devices. So, to understand those concepts clearly, it's better to know about some basics. Okay. Now, today I will start a new chapter, that is Principles of Electricity, Network Theorems and AC Principles. In this chapter, we are going to study the electricity principles, basic electricity principles, that is your voltage, current and resistance and so on. And network theorems. Network theorems are those. We are going to study simple circuits in this chapter and how to analyze those circuits. And what is voltage, what is current, and how current flows into the circuit, and what about the voltage, how voltage is applied, what are the different types in that, everything you are going to study. In that, some network theorems are nothing but some big circuits, how to simplify those circuits, that we will study in this chapter using some theorems. Okay, also with that, we are going to study alternating current principles. Okay, this is also a very important chapter, and this carries 19 marks in the final examination. Okay, so electricity. I guess these concepts you might have already studied in your SSLC, but we'll just brush it up once again, and also it is counted for examination, as I have already told. The first we will go through principles of electricity, that what is electricity. Electricity is the word which is came from a Greek term, electron, by Dr. William Gilbert, the scientist called William Gilbert, who told the word electron. Electrons in Greek means amber. Amber is nothing but, it's a resin. You can find this amber, it's very famous for its color and attraction, and you can find it on the old trees. A gum-like structure will be there. If you find in your place, you can see that old trees on the surface of the stem, you can find this thing. And also in the sea, seashore. Once a Greek philosopher, Thales of Miletus, in around 640 to 546 BC before Christ, he conducted an experiment that he took that amber and rubbed with the fur, and he observed that God attracted the feather, lightweight particles. So by that we came to know that there are two types of charges. Also later on they even conducted an experiment. They have taken a glass rod, two glass rods, and rubbed with the silk. Both the rods are rubbed with the silk, and observed that when those rods come closer, they got rippled each other. Again, they have taken ebonite rod, ebonite which is made from rubber. They rubbed with the ebonite rod is rubbed with the fur or wool, Again, those opponent rod will come closer, they repel each other. But the glass rod rubbed with the silk material was attracted towards the ebonite rod which was rubbed with the wool. That means they found attraction and in some case they found repulsion. So there might be different kinds of charges. So the scientist concluded that there are two types of charges. One is positive charge and one is negative charge. Also you can observe that when you comb your hairs in winter season, when you comb your hairs and take that comb near the bits of paper, it will attract those papers, right? And also one more thing, take a plastic chair. If you sit on that plastic chair without the touching the floor, if you rub your back with the plastic chair, or somebody beats you up on the behind of the plastic chair, and sitting on that chair only try to touch somebody, you will experience a shock. Or if someone walks on the floor, walks on the mat, plastic mat or something, after walking on the plastic mat, directly go and touch some metal, you'll experience a little electric shock. This is all because of static electricity. So because of static electricity, that means charge is there in every object. As we already know, in all the objects, in all the materials, we can find atoms. Atom is made up of protons, which is a positively charged material, electrons, negatively charged, and neutrons, which has no charge. This we have already studied. So, if the object is neutral, means in every material, every substance, protons and electrons will be in equal number, so that atom that will be in electrically neutral, you can tell. So number of protons is equal to number of electrons, so that will balance the substance, right? See what happens whenever two bodies are rubbed each other. Charges may transfer. What is this charge? Charge is nothing but electric force. That means any particle, if you can take, if it is charged, in the sense it should possess a force of attraction or repulsion. See, charge, how to charge? Charge is done by, for example, with the experiment of glass rod, they rubbed two materials. That means friction happened over there. So body can be charged by different methods, friction or by conduction or by induction or by electrical field, by electric field or by heating. These are the different methods to charge a body. See, now we came to know, for example, protons, electrons, atoms. All the objects have these protons and electrons. Protons are tightly bound to the nucleus, so they cannot move. Whereas electrons will be having less electrostatic force, so they can move from atom to atom. So what happens when the two bodies are wrapped together? Some electrons of one body may be transferred to another. As we know, electrons are negatively charged particle. If a body loses some electrons, means that body will be positively charged. If a body gains some electrons, means that body will be negatively charged. Electron and proton equal number alle irutte. When those two objects are wrapped, some electrons from this body may be transferred to this. This body got lost some electrons. That means this become positively charged and this become negatively charged. Okay. Whenever these two positively charged and negatively charged body comes closer, they will attract because of there are different two types of charges and the electrons from this body may transfer to this, make this body neutral. The same way, static electricity in the sense imbalance in charges. All the objects will be neutral in nature. Once the friction is happened, what happens? Some electrons from your body might have loosened. Or when a comb is rubbed with some fur or some cloth, the electrons from the cloth may transfer to that comb. When it is held near the light particles, those light particles are neutral, so the positive charge on that gets attracted towards that negatively charged comb. You can even do one more experiment. Take a comb and wrap with some cloth and place that comb near the stream of water, near the tap water flowing. You can observe the stream of water will bend towards the comb. Just try it. This is not harmful. At your home you can try it. So this is all because of static electricity. So electron, when a body loses some electrons, means that will be positively charged. When a body gains some electrons, means that will be negatively charged. Okay, so all the objects which contains atoms, therefore there will be protons and neutrons. That and all we have already studied. Now earthing is nothing but zero potential. That is grounding in the sense zero potential. What happens in that? Earth is a huge thing. If you take a small piece of wood or something, there are lots of atoms, billions of atoms will tell. Think about earth. Earth is a huge thing. Any body comes closer to earth will become neutral. Any body comes closer to earth will become neutral, because if you transfer some electrons to earth or take some electrons from earth, that doesn't matter with the earth. That will be at zero potential, neutral only. Okay, now we'll go to properties of charges. Each other and they play each other. And unlike chargers, attract each other. See, when a glass rod wrapped with silk material, that glass rod might have gained some electrons from the silk material. When a ebonite rod wrapped with the wool material, the ebonite rod lost some electrons and transferred to the fur. Whenever an electron gained by the glass rod, it becomes negatively charged. Ebonite rod, which transferred electrons from it, that will become positively charged. When those two come closer, they got attracted. Right? Unlike charges attract, positive negative attracts each other. Whereas if you come across positive positive charges repel each other, or negative negative charges repel each other, whereas positive negative charges attract each other. Right? Therefore, the first property of charge is like charges repel each other, whereas unlike charges attract each other. The next property is charge is conserved. That means charges can neither be created nor be destroyed. That means you cannot create any charge or you cannot destroy any charge, but the charges can transfer from one body to another. Next one is charge is quantized. That means it can take only integral values. That means Q is equal to plus or minus K mu integral. I'll explain later what is Q. Charges can be 1, 2, 3, 5, plus or minus 1. That can take only integral values. So, those are charges quantized. 1 electron, 2 electrons, 3 electrons, something like that. Billions of electrons, n number of electrons, something like that. That means mass can be affected by the motion, speed of the object. But when the body is in motion, charges will not get affected. If they lose also, they will lose complete atom, not the number of electrons will be same again. And charges descend on the outer surface of the body. The magnitude of the charge is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. If it is electron, negative charge, minus 1.6. If it is proton, that is also represented by E. Charge is represented by E. That is proton. That is plus E. Electron minus E. The magnitude on proton and electron are same. That is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. If you take electrons, that is minus 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. If you take protons, plus 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. Now, charge on a single electron, SI unit ऑगस्टिन कूलम, चार्ल्स ऑगस्टिन डी कूलम, हू कंडक्टेड एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ फोर्स बिटवीन द चार्जेस एंड चार्ज ऑन अ सिंगल इलेक्ट्रॉन. Charge on a single electron that is Q is equal to N. We will tell N is 1 single electron, Q is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. Charge on a single electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power of 1.602, you can tell. So 1 coulomb is equal to 1 electron by 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19, 1.602 you can, then it is 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons. That means 1 coulomb of charge consists of 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons. Okay, then find the number of electrons in 5 coulomb of charge. Find the number of electrons in 5 coulomb of charge. So Q is given 5 coulomb. Calculate that you'll get 3.12 into 10 to the power of 19 electrons. One coulomb of charge contains 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons, whereas 5 coulombs of charge contains 3.12 into 10 to the power of 19 electrons. Think about that. So coulomb is a very big unit. Always why in practical when talking about charge will be micro coulombs. Okay, in one more problem which is given in worked example, find the total charge on into 10 to the power of minus 19. -19 कूलम्ब. ओके सो नाउ यू पीपल केम टू नो व्हाट इज चार्ज एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ चार्जेस. हाउ टू टाइप्स ऑफ चार्जेस आर केम इनटू हाउ दे केम टू नो दैट टू टाइप्स ऑफ चार्जेस आर देयर. आई गेस यू माइट हैव स्टडीड दिस इन योर हाई स्कूल. Read the textbook. Let me know if you have any doubts. Even if you have doubts in semiconductors, you may ask now. Now, next is electric current. Charges, the flow of these charges in a conductor constitutes electric current. That is, flow of charges in a conductor, in the conductive material, constitutes electric current. The strength of the electric current is defined as, you can also, what is current in a sense, the rate of flow of charges, rate of flow of charges. That is, if Q is a charge, net amount of charge flowing through the cross section of a conductor in time t, then rate of flow of means according to time, current is equal to charge by time, that is Q by T, Ne by T. If a conductor, the current is flowing in the conductor, that means charges are flowing in the conductor, therefore you can expect a current over there. The electrons are flowing in the conductor, therefore you can expect a electric current over there. So if you take a small amount of charge BQ in a small change in time dt, then I is equal to dq by dt. You can write these cases, small amount of current, small amount of charge, that will be taken while analyzing the circuits and current. Okay, so differentiation in study in the mathematics, that time you will understand what is differentiation, that time you can understand these concepts. Okay, and the unit of collective current is ampere. The unit of electric current is ampere, which is denoted by A or amps. They call us amps. So 1 ampere means if the electric current, the unit of electric current is said to be 1 ampere. 1 ampere. How to define 1 ampere? 1 coulomb you define. How to define 1 ampere? If 1 coulomb of charge flows through a cross section of a conductor in 1 second, then the current is said to be 1 ampere. Okay, there will be a question, what is charge? Properties of charge is asked for 2 marks or 3 marks question. And unit of charge, what is 1 coulomb and what is 1 ampere and what is electric current? Okay, in tomorrow's class we will study direction of current and potential difference and so on. Thank you.